Continuing coverage of the massive fire that ravaged three apartment buildings Monday in downtown Lewiston. Lewiston's fire chief tells us that he is still not prepared to release any information regarding a cause or the focus of the investigation. In the meantime, donations for those left homeless by that fire are pouring in. WMTW News 8 Steve Minnick joins us now from where the fire took place. And Steve, it sounds like the city is really pulling together.
It really has, Tracy, and all you have to do is see the growing pile of donations a few miles from here at the YWCA and the many volunteers working to make sure those donations end up in the right hands. But this is the spot right here where on Monday some 75 people were left homeless, many of them losing absolutely everything they had.
I ran out without a shoe. My cast broke.
Adriana Garcia is still wearing the same clothes from Monday when she fled her burning apartment. Living with friends now, she says the fire destroyed everything she owned.
And I've never asked for help. Now that I need it, I'm getting it, and I'm very thankful.
The outpouring is just, it's really remarkable.
In just the past 24 hours, as word of this donation site at the YWCA has spread across town, dozens of people have hauled in bags full of clothing, toys, and home goods for the victims. As many as 75 people left with very little, if anything at all.
I've never been through what those people have been through, but I can only imagine what it must feel like. It's all I can do to help.
Right now, they're just overwhelmed with everything that's ahead of them. And if we can make it easier for them, then that's what we're here for.
With so many donations coming in so quickly, though, the Y is looking for help as well, asking for volunteers to spend a few hours sorting through clothes. Many have already stopped in.
We're not working today, and we just decided to just donate a little time to help out.
One thing about tragedies like this, you know, a tight-knit community, they all come together.
Coming together to help victims like Adriana Garcia, who says she's overwhelmed by the graciousness as she admittedly struggles to figure out what's next.
It's hard, and I still haven't grasped it. I have my little spurs where it hits me really hard.
Now, along with the clothing and household items, the folks at the YWCA are also asking people to donate rubber or plastic totes so the victims can carry away their items. Live in Lewiston, Steve Minnick, WMTW News 8.